Morning. So just kind of start off here. We had a transaction this morning. We traded Michael Roberts this morning. Just, you know, again, roster movement is something that's pretty common at this time of year, and we're always going to try to do what's in the best interest of the team for us, both the short term and the long term, to try to make us, you know, as competitive as possible. Obviously, with the tight end position, kind of, you know, in conversation here, you know, we have good competition in the room right now. We had an opportunity to, you know, move on from Mike and you know, hopefully potentially get something in the future for it. So it was a good opportunity for us as a team to do that and to build our team long term. There's always situations too, you know, sometimes when roster movement happens, there's other positions that may affect the overall total number. We are currently at 89. We are not at 90. So we do have an open roster spot at the moment. It's really kind of it on that you know, topic. It's kind of, you know, happens a lot. Roster movement happens every day. So with that being said, you know, today will be our last OTA practice. You know, really looking forward to kind of try to pull some things together here. We're in the fourth week of, you know, OTAs, finishing up mini camp last week, as we were talking about before, working through different situations of the game, getting closer to, you know, trying to play more realistic type football situations through the course of practice by down and distance, field position, game situations, things like that. So be a little bit more of a practice where you'll see a lot of that kind of movement in and out between offense, defense, special teams, things that correlate maybe more to game type situations, communication, execution, and basic awareness of kind of the situation. So should be a pretty good day. See what the weather looks like, but you know, that's all right. We're gonna go outside and get some practice in. Okay. Questions.
We do have in the tight end room. What have you seen? Now you've had Logan Thomas around a few weeks from him in particular.
Yeah. You know what? Obviously someone we're learning here as we go through the spring. Really smart guy. I think his background as a quarterback helps him from an overall concept understanding of different positions. Guy that can do a lot of things out there on the field. Certainly, you know, spring evaluation is always one thing, and we'll see what it takes to look like when we get the pads on. But as far as a guy that comes in every single day, does what he's asked to do, works really hard, has learned the playbook very quickly, you know, from a information standpoint, his execution has been really good from that aspect of it so far through the spring. So, you know, guy we're excited about, and we'll just kind of see how it goes as we progress through, just like all the guys in that room, in that situation. Mike, you had one.
Yeah. Was that something once you drafted TJ and Isaac, was that when that kind of started happening where you're like, all right, this may be an overloaded room?
Sure. No, I wouldn't say you kind of go immediately into that mode, you know, because you don't really know how things are going to go from through the course of the spring. You obviously always want to try to evaluate your players as much as you can and try to keep as many good players as you can and evaluate them as you go through. Sometimes opportunities come up in different facets, and maybe the direction of the team might change, or things might change from a schematic standpoint, or points of emphasis might change as you work through the last 4 weeks. You know, it's our good opportunity here to evaluate everybody over 4 weeks and see what we have on that side of the ball, on all sides of the ball, in every position room. And like I said, you know, with the roster, sometimes movement on a roster in general can be affected not only by that position room, but also other positions that are also out on the field. Whether those are positions that we say we need to add some extra guys, or, you know, as we gear towards training camp, what does our practice depth look like in order to get through practice, and some of the things that we need to do based on, you know, guys' availability, which, you know, we'll have better answers as we get towards training camp, the start of training camp, to see what that all looks like. In general, I don't mind going at this time of year with 89 on the roster and having an extra roster spot available, just because, you know, there will be some sort of movement here by all teams over the course of the next several weeks. And I think in general, it gets a little bit difficult as you go on break and you're not around the facility, and, you know, you don't have an opportunity to get a hold of guys and actually, you know, explain what's going on. Sometimes it's an okay philosophy to go in with 89. And, you know, if you're adding somebody, you're just adding someone at that point, you know, not releasing anybody also.
Just kind of give yourself that flexibility,
yep.
or are there positions that you're looking at right now that you're like, I need,
yep,
X?
Both. It definitely, from a general philosophy standpoint, it's good to have the flexibility, you know, in that position, because you know there's going to be movement coming up in the next couple of weeks. But we will always evaluate our roster, and we are in a position where we're saying, all right, well, you know, do we want to add someone in this position, or do we want to add another player in this position? And we'll take the next couple of weeks to look at it and see if there's somebody out there that we do feel like we do want to add.
Obviously, Jerome Cunningham was here a little bit last year, but kind of unique situation, and I don't know other than maybe a quarterback where you kind of wipe the slate clean of an entire position. Are there any challenges in doing that at tight end?
You know what? I think there probably are in certain situations. I guess for us right now, we're just trying to get the best players we can in each position. I would say on the offensive side of the ball, everything has kind of been a start of a new with, you know, the additional of Daryl Bevel and kind of a new system. So at this point, it's all kind of start over from that aspect of it. So we're just kind of progressing from the last 4 weeks, doing our evaluations and then moving forward. So, you know, nothing unusual as far as that.
And wide receiver is another position where you really have numbers and competition. How do you separate out the final couple of spots there? And where does a guy like Andy Jones who's shown something might fit in there?
Sure. You know, I mean, obviously at this time of year, it's hard to kind of get through final separation until we go through training camp and kind of see evaluation of what everybody looks like as we get towards, you know, we put the pads on and we get into camp and we evaluate. I think Andy in general, obviously, is someone that's been around here that has worked extremely hard. He's been very adaptable to, you know, a lot of different positions that he's been asked to play. He's a guy that can go in multiple different facets of the game on offense. Obviously, you know, special teams is a big part of what he does also, which is a big contribution to what he does. He's a big guy. He's strong. He's powerful. He's tough. He's smart. So those are all good attributes that will allow him to go in and compete. And, you know, in the end, we'll see how it all plays itself out. But I'm certainly doing everything he can to increase his value on our team. Absolutely.
Along those same lines, quarterback looks like a spot where you could have some pretty good competition as well. Just curious, you know, a guy you guys went after, Rashawn Melvin, just maybe what he's shown you this spring, how he kind of gets in the mix.
Yeah, and another guy that I've had familiarity with from before, he's a big long corner. He's a guy that familiar with the different techniques and the fundamentals that, you know, we've played through the course of the years. He's a guy that kind of naturally just kind of falls into some of the scheme things that we do and some of the stuff that we do on the field. Tough guy, another guy that really kind of works extremely hard every single day. So you want as much competition as possible out there. You know, I think the corner position is always an interesting one, especially, you know, it correlates hand in hand with the wide receiver position. And as we've all seen through the course of the years, there's some big, fast, strong wide receivers that keep coming out of college and are producing in the league. So certainly you want to have the best matchup possible when you can at the corner position on those guys. Doesn't always mean that the physical stats are the same. You know, obviously, however they play and compete at that position is most important. But he's just another guy that, you know, gives us a great opportunity to go out there and compete at that position.
Housekeeping things before you break for the summer. First, with in regards to Slane Harrison, what have they communicated to you, or what are your expectations, I guess, for whether they'll be here for the start of training?
Sure. Again, you know, I think I've addressed that issue. I'm just going to really focus on the guys that are here as far as that's concerned and talk about them and whatever communications we have with players in those situations are, you know, kept private between us and the player. So, you know, look, when we get back for training camp, we always obviously expect everybody to be where they're supposed to be when they're there. And, you know, we deal with it and we go from there. So I don't really look into that too much.
And then the other one, you sort of talked about this a little bit just in vague terms, general terms the other week, but can you explain what you did the last 2 days? You know, how you don't always use your OTA days. You can go back to revert to a day two or a phase 2 day.
Sure.
Just, you know, the thought process, I guess, behind it.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, a little bit kind of philosophy-wise, and we do things a little bit different where we do our mandatory the previous week, right? A lot of teams do it the last week, and a lot of teams through the course of OTAs will change up a last day in the, you know, spring or do something along those lines. I always felt that it's better to do that with a OTA day based on the rules and everything that you're kind of restricted by, as opposed to a mandatory minicamp day where you have the maximum amount of time with the players and on the field and all that stuff and try to utilize all that time. So we do that the third week. And then, you know, as you get into the fourth week, as you do decide to try to maybe change pace or see how you are as far as on schedule, not on schedule with your installation and your development and where the players are, where the health of your team is at that point of the year, you know, you try to analyze what's best. And, you know, if you want to change things up, it's okay. You're not, you know, you're just utilizing or moving an OTA day. You're also by rule allowed to schedule OTA days, you know, for in the last week. So we'll always maximize that time from a scheduling standpoint and then just be ready to monitor and adjust based on what the team, you know, needs, what it looks like, what it feels like, or whether opportunities come up that we think are good for the team from that standpoint. So just having the flexibility, I guess, is the best thing for us to be able to not have everything so set in stone where we can move things around based on, you know, what's best.
I set with joint practices for the two, for Patriots and Texans?
You know what? I think we're, again, we're kind of waiting on some information, you know, as we kind of push through the spring here. So we're just kind of working through some of those situations and possibilities right now. You know what? I don't really know. We'll get there when we get there.
What was your sense of relief when you didn't get Hard Knocks?
My sense of relief when we didn't get Hard Knocks. You know, again, like I think I've talked about Hard Knocks. I think everybody at the NFL Films does a great job. So, you know, those guys are one of the reasons that I fell in love with the game. There was a great video that came out a long time ago called Crunch Course. It was one of the ones that I remember most. And, you know, I love the history of that. And the message of it was awesome at the time. And, you know, for us, we're just focused on exactly what affects us right now. And, you know, right now it's finishing off the spring well and getting ready for training camp.
Do you think or know your team's better than this time a year ago as you go into the gap before training camp?
You know what? It's a great question. I don't know. It's hard to compare, right? Like, I don't really know where we were last year compared to where we were this year, because it really doesn't matter until what the end results are. So for us, we're working in a good direction. I feel good about where we are, feel good about practice and what we've been able to accomplish from that standpoint. You always feel better second year than you do the first year. So I would say and hope that we're ahead of where we were last year, but really, in the end, we'll find out when we get to the fall. One more. Yeah.
Reporters, players, is the time of year when we get some downtime. Sure. You personally, I mean, how do you approach these 4 or 5 weeks? Do you actually take some time to sit dial down?
Yeah, sure. It's kind of hard, right? You know, you'd like the downtime. Obviously, the family time is the most important thing, but you're also about to step into a very high speed world when you get back into training camp. So it's a delicate balance.
I know I'm gonna do one little trip with my wife. We're gonna go up to Traverse City, take our dogs up there. She doesn't like to leave our dogs anymore. Ever since we took a trip and we came home and they were bad for like a month. So that, and then just keeping up with my training. You know, trying to hit the ground running when we get back. We made a lot of progress this off season. You know, learning the offense, working hard, getting to know teammates, and you know, you don't want to take a step back in this time off.
Is that really the main concern? I mean, you said it right there, not taking a step back. I mean, how important is it for guys to keep that mindset of continuous improvement all through this?
I think it's a mindset we have. I mean, we work really hard here, and we take pride in that. And, you know, I have faith that everybody's going to come back ready to go. So really looking forward to it. We worked hard through this spring, and you're going to get some time off to be with your families, you know, do whatever you want to do before the season starts and be ready to go, you know, late July, whenever the report date is.
Cherry Festival, is that what you brought to Traverse City for?
So we're going to go up there because she rides equestrian. So there's a big equestrian show up there. And we actually went up there for the bye week last year, and it was awesome. It was cold, but it was really beautiful. So it's nice to be able to be somewhere within driving distance. Yeah, it's phenomenal.
Beautiful.
Yeah. I never realized until we went up for the bye week last year how beautiful Northern Michigan was. I hear it all the time, but didn't get to see it to now.
You take 22 up?
I don't even know. I just put it in the GPS. I'm a millennial. I just play with the GPS.
How do you like the work? Oh, go ahead, Dean.
Where do you see the progress? I mean, when do you even compare it in your own mind to where you were at a year ago at this time?
I think that's one of the cool things about football is every year is a new year. So, you know, you don't really get into comparing it. You know, like I said, I think we worked really hard this offseason. You know, I think we got a great locker room, and, you know, I can speak to us having a great group in the offensive line room. So, you know, we worked really hard to digest the playbook, come out here, and put it into action on the field. And then, like I said, it's just going to be really important for us to just come back ready to go once we find out our report date.
What is the important thing for you guys with no pads on? I mean, what do you want to do? How do you want to get better over the last 2 months? How do you get better as an offensive line some of the restrictions that you have?
Yeah, I mean, I think the huge thing is fundamentals. We're going to get plenty of hitting in training camp. You know, we know that. And the huge thing that we can work on is, you know, alignment, hand placement, footwork, you know, the details of the football game. Because, you know, we know once the pads come on, we're going to be able to hit plenty. We're going to get plenty of work at that. But to establish a good base of fundamentals and work really hard at that, there is a lot of benefit to it.
How different were they under Bevel's system than they were maybe under Jim Bob? Was it a big difference in terms of some of the fundamentals, footwork, hand place, or some of the things you had to do, or is that just transversal over?
Yeah, I mean, we've had Jeff for 2 years now, so, you know, we love him in the O-line room. He does a really great job, so, you know, there's been you know, carry over with what we do with Jeff and our individual techniques. So yeah, and then other than that, it's just trying to coming in and trying to learn the new offense, digest as much information as you can. So like I said, once we do get to training camp and you know, preseason, whatever it may be, that we'll be able to execute it.
Is there a point in OTAs where it doesn't maybe feel new anymore, the offense, where you guys sort of clear a hurdle in
regard? I mean, yes and no. I mean, there's always going to be nuance, you know, to the plays or whatever defenses you're going to be going against. So, do I think we have a good understanding of it? I do. And I think guys worked really hard individually and together, collectively, you know, in meetings and whatever time they had to be on the same page. You know, it's not that one guy needs to be out there. No, we all need to be on the same page working together as a team out there.
Hey, Taylor, how do you spend the next, you know, month? I mean, what do you do to take care of your body to get ready for the long haul of the, you know, the grind of the season, I guess, that's ahead?
Yeah, I think, first it's really important to be able to spend time with your family because, you know, once the season starts, it's going to be, you know, the next however many months. So, you know, put your time into them because they deserve it. We've been working really hard here for this stretch. So, you know, whatever you want to do, family-wise, trips, do that. And then just, you know, continue to build on the base foundation of training and football knowledge that we set here, because I think we put in a lot of good work, and hopefully that'll, you know, continue.
And you're one of the leaders of this team. Are you at all concerned about not having Slay Harrison? I mean, that whole situation and how it might develop or what it might mean for the fall?
No. I mean, I just focus on the guys that are here working hard. You know, that's a situation that I don't know anything about, so really just concerned with, you know, our offensive line group and us working hard to be better. So, I don't really have much of a comment about that.
How do you know? You expect good competition among that group in the fall with what you guys have kind of learned over the last 2 months?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's something we want to build all across the team in all position groups is competition, because that competition, you know, will make you become a better player. It kind of breeds excellence. So, you know, I think we want competition all across the board, you know, whether it be within your position or the guys you're going to be practicing against, whatever it may be, you know, competition is going to make us better.
How do you know or think this team is better than a year ago?
Well, and I said it earlier, I think the funny thing about football is you don't have to go back and compare year to year. It's going to be a fresh start. You know, there's going to be new guys in the locker room. So I don't think we're really in the business of, you know, comparing year to year because it's going to be a fresh start for us.
There's different guys mixing inside, that center and guard. What are the challenges that presents to you being on the outside, working with different guys?
I mean, a lot of us have been here together for a couple years now, so you know, there's some, you know, fluidity with them rolling guys through, and that's just part of the competition aspect. And you know, whatever opportunity you get to work hard and show the coaches what you can do, you got to take advantage of it.
Do you have any first impressions of Pope besides him being a massive, you know, man? I mean, gave him a lot of money to sign.
So. Yeah, I mean, he's a guy that came out here and, you know, was trying to work hard, and you know, coming in as a rookie, it can kind of be a whirlwind for you. But pretty much what you can ask of a guy is to come in, try to learn as much as you can, practice hard, and I think he's been doing a good job of that.
Maybe just along the same lines, Crosby, you know, his second year now, there's a comfort level that comes with obviously having, you know, been here, done that. What have you seen from him, maybe his growth a little bit?
Yes, I mean, I think he's got some more confidence, obviously, with, you know, getting more exposure to the game at this level. You're going to get more and more confidence to be able to go out there and execute your job. You know, so he's a good piece for us, so... like I said, it's great for us to have competition not only in our group but in all position groups because it's going to make everybody better.
They lit the fires under our feet, chased us into the hills. Oh, they let the wolves off of the leash, should have finished the kill. We got ashes on our shoes and an outcast attitude, and we're all immune cause we know the truth is viral. We might be the outsiders, but the in crowd is so loud right now. And we might be the outsiders, but the in crowd is so loud right now. to the cool now. Hand in our heads, we fit right in. Cause they gave us the fuel. We got ashes on our shoes and an outcast attitude. Yeah, we're all immune, cause you know the truth is viral. So out right now. Yeah, we might be the outsiders, but the in crowd is so out right now. No bones, no drama. We live how we wanna. Yeah, we might be the outsiders, be the outsiders, the outsiders. We don't need good reputations. We might be the outside.